Since tomorrow night is Yutesh Kislev, this 19th day of the month of Kislev, the day of the liberation of the first Lubavitcher Rebbe from prison and the beginning of the true spreading out of the wellsprings of Chabad Hasidic thought. So I'd like to continue to talk about what we started yesterday concerning how the Alter Rebbe changed so much of our perspective on Judaism and who we are and what we are and what our purpose is as Jews in this world. So, of course, many people just look at themselves, I'm a body, hopefully I have a soul, and really, whatever that soul is, I hope that soul will help me somehow to fulfill my bodily purpose, i.e., that it will inspire me to be able to do more Torah and mitzvahs, to study and to learn, to be a better person, to overcome my yetzer hara, and to be able to sanctify myself in all of my actions and activities. And that's all true, and that's all very good, and that's all basic Judaism, so to say. But the Alter Rebbe came along and he put a whole different level of the different dimension into the ball game. And he said the following. He said, really, it's not just that you are a body and your soul will help guide you as far as fulfilling your purpose. He said, really, you are a soul. And your soul has a purpose and your body helps the soul to fulfill its purpose. In other words, do we look at our lives as just a body that might have some type of soul purpose or a soul that has a purpose being in this world to accomplish things? So he explains how the soul really has a drive of its own. And every soul is unique. And there's no two souls that are the same because you wouldn't need to have two souls in this world that both have the same purpose. Because every soul has its very specific purpose, has to go through its own specific trials and tribulations, its own tests, opportunities, talents, and greatness, and also its own failures and its own times to really look back and see how life didn't turn out the way we wanted it to be. But that's unique, and that's your autobiography. But that's because of your soul, not just because of your body. So as a result, he explained that if we look at ourselves as a soul, then we look at ourselves as from a very different perspective. And that really turns our view of ourselves and Judaism upside down. So let's take one example. Just one example from the Alter Rebbe. Let's take eating, which is a very basic human need. And God created us in a way that we not only we need to eat, we want to eat, and we have a desire to eat. So he explains the following. He explains that basically, according to Chassidut, the fact is that the soul wants a certain amount of food to eat because the soul has a drive and a need and a desire to elevate the physical world. And when it elevates the physical world, it's fulfilling its purpose. So it wants to eat in order to take the sparks, godly sparks that are in each of the things that we want to eat, just as in everything that we use in the physical world around us, but in specifically concerning eating, to really elevate those sparks. So when we approach food, when we approach anything in our physical world, all of our belongings, all of our possessions, the things we use, the things we consume, we keep in mind that, wait a second, there's a soul reason why I'm involved with this at this time. And I need to really maintain that and connect to it and realize that there's a higher purpose why I'm doing what I'm doing. So as we continue to look at Judaism from a little bit of a different perspective, let's prepare for tomorrow night and for Thursday during the day, for all the special occasions and all the forbringings and all of the good occasions, the special readings. If you want to go on Chabad.org, you can find a lot about Yutesh Kislev, a lot about the Alter Rebbe, a lot about his teachings and about Chassidut that he brought to the world. And God willing, it should help you be a better person and be happier, be more fulfilled, and be able to better accomplish your soul purpose in this world.